malaria drugs scrutinized against resistant head and neck cancers. Cancer treatments are uncomfortable due to different side effects, but that's nothing to patients who receive worse news, having cancer that's resisting treatment. Although many research groups are looking into how to beat resistant cancers, we still have a long way to go. Recently, a group of experts identified an existing drug that could help treat chemotherapy-resistant head and neck cancers. But before we go on, the study doesn't claim that the drug has been proven for clinical use against resistant cancers. More studies would be required to solidify the findings in this presented research. The findings are just telling us that scientists should investigate which drugs might boost therapies for resistant cancers. Published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, scientists at the University of Pittsburgh paved the way for a clinical trial that combines cisplatin and hydroxychloroquine, a popular drug used to treat malaria. When caring for patients with head and neck cancers, I often see chemotherapy fail. Cisplatin is a very important chemotherapy drug, but tumor resistance to cisplatin is a huge problem, said head and neck surgeon Dr. Umama Heswar Duvuri. Despite the prowess of cisplatin, a protein called TMEM16A has been linked to cisplatin resistance in patient tumors. If this protein becomes overexpressed, the chances of a patient surviving will be cut down significantly. In head and neck cancers, 30% of cases demonstrated overexpression of that protein. When the team investigated resistant tumors, they were surprised by the connection between TMEM16A and cancer. The protein belongs to a group called ion channels that straddle the outer envelope of cells. The protein group plays a role in regulating muscle and nerve activation and transport of salt and water by giving a passageway for chloride ions. Their investigation showed how tumors resisted cisplatin. Normal levels help a cellular recycling and waste disposal system called lysosomes. But in excessive levels, the protein boosts lysosomes and this expels cisplatin effectively out of the cell. Here's where the anti-malaria drug comes in. Hydroxychloroquine inhibits lysosomal function, so in theory, it should stop the ejection of cisplatin. The team implanted human tumors onto fertilized chicken eggs. Then, they treated them with both drugs. The treated eggs had greater tumor cell death than eggs treated with cisplatin only. Mice with tumors were also treated with both drugs, and results showed that the combination led to higher tumor cell death than those treated with cisplatin alone. The research is now moving toward phase 2 clinical to treat head and neck cancer patients. What do you think about the approach used in this study? Do you know someone who has been diagnosed with resistant cancer? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.